Hey, beautiful people, Christopher Green, Jesus Christ is King. It's a beautiful day. It is Sunday, June 6, 2021. I want to share with you the love and the salvation of our one true King, Jesus, and how all of us and how you can be a light in a very dark world. Because just because it's dark does not mean that we can't spread hope and love and absolute joy. Salvation to everybody who wants to receive that. And I encourage you all today to not just like this video, but open up your heart and mind to our one true King who has saved me, my family, many of my loved ones, and many people that I continue to pray for today. And I give all the glory to Him. Jesus calls us to a higher calling. And I'm speaking to my brothers and sisters out there. He calls us to a higher level for those of us that know, that do not remain ignorant, that understand, that have that understanding. It is a huge responsibility that we share that message. And far few people in the world are bold enough to share that. Far few people in the world are bold enough to speak freely about what they know to be the truth. And Jesus, not only has He saved us and shown His immense love, but He is coming. He is coming. It is prophesied in the Holy Book, in the Bible, and He will return in all of His glory. And in His second coming, He will come with judgment. He will come with judgment to a very dark world. So we must understand that as Christians, we've already won in the light and in the truth that is Jesus. I think of my brother who's been fighting cancer over the last several years. He's having a tough time right now. And I spoke with him a few days ago. But one thing that stands out for me personally, when he was first diagnosed with bone cancer, two years, I think, almost to this day, is he said, "Christopher, I knew that God was real. I knew that He was real. Because in that single moment, when I thought that my life was over, I knew by looking at everyone around me and feeling it in my heart, that all there was on this planet, this experiment, this amazing thing of which we all coexist worldwide, and all of humanity is connected. We are all brothers and sisters, no matter our religion, the color of our skin, the sex, all the confusion that's out there, it doesn't even matter." He said, "I just knew that God was love, and that that is all that He, and I believe we, needed to know." In fact, it tells us in the Bible, I'm going off the top of my head here, it would be better to go maimed into heaven and into eternal life, missing a leg or missing an eye or whatever is causing you to sin, than it would be to live your whole life, maybe 90 or 100 years old, a centenarian, and not know Him and not be saved and to be eternally damned. But what I think people commonly misunderstand about Jesus is Jesus isn't just about judgment. Okay, Jesus is about love. He is about forgiveness. And that, to me, is the fundamental message of our Savior and King Jesus Christ. Having died and sacrificed Himself for literally all the lost, all the forgotten, and the saved, in that moment, that earth-shattering, cataclysmic moment of which the veil was broken and Jesus Christ died on that cross and then rose 3 days later, a miracle, eyewitnesses that continues to this day, that has transformed and transfigured even our current history as we push forward and emerge forward of what we read about is coming in the book. People ask me all the time, Christopher, how have you known all these things? You must be a genius. How did you know? How did you have this foresight? How do you have this vision for the future? How do you understand the trends that are coming? Well, hasn't been very hard, ladies and gentlemen. It's all right here in the Holy Book. All you have to do is read it, and it's being told what comes. Jesus is love. He is the ultimate sacrifice. And Satan in this world is selling greed, jealousy, sex, envy. He poses as an angel of light, but is quite the contrary. It's that of darkness. And of course, Satan fell and wanted to be God. And now he spends most of his time trying to convince you that he's an angel of light when that couldn't be any further from the truth, because the truth is he wants your soul. He wants you to be a part of that darkness, and all of us, myself included, continually are tested by him on a daily basis. So all of us, all of you tuning in, are going to need the full armor of God, especially in this environment, every single day. And think about this in the perspective of a media perspective. Media is toxic, right? All the media, on your TV, Hollywood films, social media especially, which, what does social media teach most of us as we see it? We see people living supposedly the greatest lives, right? It teaches us greed and envy and jealousy, like, well, why can't I have a life like that? Or why can't I do that? Or, you know, why aren't things that good for me? Well, most of that, I'm here to tell you guys, isn't real, and it's an illusion, because those things, even if you have them, take it from a guy who is actually super blessed by God, those things will not save you, and they will not make you happy, because true joy and love does not come from this world. It doesn't come from a Rolex, it doesn't come from a fast car, and it doesn't come from a pretty house. It comes from knowing the truth. Matthew 20:16, so the last will be first into the kingdom of heaven, and the first will be last. For many are called, but few are chosen. Let me repeat that. So the last will be first, the lost, the forgotten, the homeless, those that no one care about, the drug addicts, the prostitutes, those that society has marginalized will be the first to enter the kingdom of heaven. Think about that for a moment. The last will be first and the first will be last. For many are called, but few are chosen. And I ask you, tuning in, for those of you that are called, I believe myself to be one of those that have been called. You have a responsibility too to that calling. A wondrous and amazing and beautiful responsibility. Jesus Christ died for the forgotten. He died for you. He died for the lost. And the saved, equally. Reminds me of the parable of the lost sheep. What do you think if a man has 100 sheep and one of them goes astray? Does he not leave the 99 and go to the mountains to seek the one that is straying? And if he should find it, assuredly, I say to you, he rejoices more over that sheep than over the 99 that did not go astray. Even so, it is not the will of your Father who is in heaven that one of these little ones should perish. That parable tells us, and again, I will repeat, that Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, would rather search out the one lost sheep high into the mountaintops to save you, when you might think you've been the one marginalized and you've been the one forgotten, or you've been the one that's gone astray. He would rather save you. Does he not leave the 99 and go to the mountains to seek the one that is straying? You know, the revelation for today, in today's video, to give you hope and joy and salvation should be of the revelation of Jesus Christ's reward. That simply all of us, all of you tuning in, have equal rights, equal opportunity to ask him into your heart, to acknowledge Jesus Christ, our Lord, as the one true King and our Savior, the one and the only one that provides hope in a dark, dark world. You know, I think about the health events that have been going on recently, and I'd like you to keep this in mind as I read these words to you in closing, Matthew 16:24. Then Jesus said to his disciples, if anyone desires to come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever desires to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Let me repeat and put this into context of the recent health events that we've been living through, and all the fear and the depression and the anxiety and the lockdowns and the unknown. I repeat, for whoever desires to save his life in this world will lose it. Poof. It will be gone. But whoever loses his life for Jesus, truth, love, hope, and a helping hand to maybe some of you that might have gone astray. All of us, this grand experiment that is a temporal and temporary thing, of which my prayer for all of you today is to seek the eternal kingdom and eternal life. For what is it a man to bet on this world and lose his soul? That, ladies and gentlemen, is the truth. I want you to think about this today. Hopefully this gives you some perspective. Sunday, June 6, 2021. I am not a perfect vessel. I, myself, have gone astray at times. But I remind myself of a higher calling and one that I believe all of you should seek. That just because we live in darkness, and just because you are imperfect or I am imperfect, and we have our failings and are falling out, there is still no reason that you and we and I can't be amazing lights in a dark world, selling the truth, hope, love for those that need it most in a world that is absolutely fallen and lost. So my brothers and sisters, for those of you that do know Christ, please share that word today. Be bold. Some of you probably don't have a platform like I do to share that message, but have courage just with a friend or a family member that maybe you should call today to remind them, or maybe just to open the door, to creak it open so maybe that they would see. Because all of us are on our own path and own journey, and none of us, Christians, non-Christians alike, are better than anyone else. I love you guys. There is hope, and this is the truth. I'm Christopher Green. Jesus Christ is our King. Blessings to all of you. Please share this worldwide.